Citizen Television.
And welcome to another episode of the Planetary Persuader. I am Kozmic Kev, your host, and this is our outdoor springtime backyard useful odds and ends section of the yard, we'll say. So, first of all, I want to say happy Easter. Or really what it comes down to is spring equinox. And that happened today at 3:45 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time. So here on the west coast of North America, we are happy to welcome in spring, although we really didn't get much of a winter. As everybody knows, we're in the dry lands. However, what we have today is Mars and Uranus in the first house, along with the Sun, making its way there. We still have Mercury and Neptune in the 12th house in Pisces, and Chiron's there as well. We've got Venus and Taurus now. So there's definitely a more sensual feel to our behavior in every way. Jupiter still retrograde in Leo. We had a new moon eclipse earlier this morning. I'm glad that you all survived that. It's good to be here with you. We've got Saturn in Sagittarius. So Saturn is loosely trining the Sun this week. We've just had a new moon. This is the perfect time to make new goals. This is the perfect time to set an awareness towards something good. Okay, so we also find this is a really kind of a rowdier time because now daylight is longer than nighttime. And so there's a greater ability to do things outside without using any artificial lighting. Anyhow, with that said, welcome to the freshness, welcome to the new, welcome to what originally was Easter. Spring equinox, and we're going sign by sign right now for your horoscope in today's episode of The Planetary Persuader. Well, greetings Aries, and welcome to your horoscope. So this is what I'd say for you right now. All things are new. We're starting out with five planets in Aries. And so I'm counting the south node of the moon. Mars, Sun, Uranus, and the moon. So, this goes for Saturday as well, you know. Sunday morning, moon will be in Taurus. We'll be dealing with a different vibe. But right now, there's this real urge to move forward. And if there's ever been a time for you that you needed to make changes in your life, now will be the easiest time to make them. And it'll probably be the best time. It'll be the most freeing and the most liberating time for you. Your challenges will not get easier than they are now, so I would definitely attend to them. As you act, things will move. You've got a lot of drive with Mars in the first house. You've got a lot of unexpected possibilities with Uranus in the first house. You're being more conscious of who you are, what your will is with the Sun in the first house. Venus in the second, you know, you're more inclined to want to get luxurious things or to eat sweets, or you might even be involved in music more now because that rules your ears and the voice. And Jupiter in the creative fifth house is helping you expand yourself, and there's this beautiful grand trine in fire that's very motivational. Enjoy. Well, hello Taurus, and welcome to your horoscope. So, now, when we go through what I would call a 12th house period, this is a period where it's really easy to be unconscious. It's a really easy time to be part of your own undoing. And it's also sort of the harvest season before your birthday comes and your new time. So everything that you did in the last 11 months, it's coming to light. And secret motives, ways in your own life that you feel isolated, these things are much more activated right now. And there is no need for you to fear. We've got Venus in the first house giving you an easy manner to you. But we've also got Saturn in the eighth house, and so a lot of ego-crushing circumstances can happen. You've got an active social network with all the planets in your 11th right now transiting. Family issues need to be looked at. All the places where you feel vulnerable and more emotional, those are the places to discover. Well, hello Gemini, and welcome to your horoscope. So, the thing about Gemini is we, Mercury ruled. We have a natural curiosity. We try to look at both sides of every issue. In Aries time, it activates our 11th house. We want to meet helpful friends. We want to help prepare for our future. We want to be in a place that allows us some maximum amount of freedom of movement from one group of people or one center of information to another. So make new friends. Acknowledge the people that are helpful in your life, and do things like throw surprise parties for them to appreciate them. You still have a lot of intelligent decisions to make at the workplace. You're going through a lot of transformation. Partnership issues are weighing a lot heavier than they used to. And Jupiter is in your third house, expanding your sense of communication and giving you more of a curiosity. Also, we've got North Node in your fifth house, so you're desiring to be more creative, to work from your heart, to make work like play. Well, hello, Cancer, and welcome to your horoscope. And so, water sign. Okay, so. Certain things work for you, certain things don't. Right now, you're being called to leadership. You're being called to be the leader of a game, to run your own business, or to be more responsible at the workplace where you do work. So, career is really in focus this week for you. And by next weekend, you know, moon will be in your sign and everything will be all comfy and cozy again. But right now you have a responsibility to make things happen in a way that will lead to a happier ending and lead for opportunities for yourself to eventually be promoted and be able to move on in any way. So, you know, it's kind of like when everybody at work gets sick and you're the only one left, you know, and so you just do the best you can. And soon you may learn simpler things and you learn what's really important versus what's not important. And from all of this, you know, it's public pressure too. This is what people want, you know. Oh, sometimes we hate that. But all the same, you want to be able to move ahead, and this is how you do it. So, Let your talents and skills be seen. Well, hello, Leo, and welcome to your horoscope. So, as a Leo, and it's Aries time, this is ninth house. You ready to go back to school? Are you ready to get a higher certificate of learning? Are you willing to stretch your intellectual curiosity? Has there been a trip that you've always wanted to take, but you never were able to take it until now? And now that you're able to take this trip, you feel a lot more satisfaction. You feel a lot more heart, a lot more love, a lot of enrichment that you can pass on to other people. Now, you've had this extra blessing. Even if Jupiter's retrograde, Jupiter's slowing down. It's focusing that energy in the early part of the middle section of Leo. So, how much love is enough? There is never enough. You know, there is always enough. The thing is how do we open it? How do we surround ourselves with that love? How do we take it to that place? We'll learn more about it. Acts of generosity. That's something you're really good at. Giving to others, gifting to others. This is a time, you know, this is a time where you can work with that kind of energy. And you can put things in a better perspective. When I look at Venus in your midheaven right now, I'm thinking to myself, you know, this is a time to be more creative, be more artistic in the workplace. Show that you've got a flair and you've got a certain knowledge of these beautiful things. And try things differently. Take risks. This is what's going to actually add up to something bigger. Well, hello, Virgo. And welcome to your horoscopes of Virgo. Aries time rules your eighth house. And so what we know about the eighth house is, you know, people generalize it as transformation. I mean, boy, is that a loaded word. But what I would say is that it deals with birth, sex, and death. Things that we like to keep hidden in our culture. The other thing is other hidden stuff, hidden knowledge, like occult knowledge. You don't think some of the largest corporations engage in occultic rituals to keep their power? Woo! They do. You know, they cover all their bases. I think the thing is that it is the light. It is the sun that melts the light, the ice, you know? So if you're in the light, you're in the warmth. If you're in the dark, you're in the cold. And the light can penetrate the darkness, but darkness cannot penetrate the light. And the light is growing, and you're in a place of good fortune, and, but the deal is that you gotta do your spiritual work. You gotta do your discipline. You gotta do your ritual. And the other thing is that this, the eighth house is opposite of the second. We say that's other people's property. And so what you gotta do is allow other people to have their property. Allow other people to have their power. Don't try and be a control freak, Virgo. You know, because this is how you sabotage yourself right now. Don't do that. But what I want you to do is allow them to have it and then ask for help. I know you're so independent, you hate doing this, but ask for help, because you know what? You bless other people when you allow them to bless you. So you got to take that, you know, and say, you know, I could really use a hand right now. All right, this would feel good. You know, maybe sometimes you're in a crisis and you say, well, this isn't the real me. I'm more like this. And then so we adjust it. We make it better for all. Hello, Libra. Welcome to your horoscope. I mean, I know you certainly would want to make it better for all. The middle sign of the zodiac, of course you would. So what I see with you is we're in a place right now where you have a lot of strong desire. You're just coming down from this new moon experience, this eclipse, even though it was more in the Virgo Pisces axis, it's still close to you, especially if you're born, say, like the 23rd, 24th, 25th of September, those Libras. Oh, man. You know, you're feeling hard change right now. There's newness. Everything is weighing on your partnership issues. So where we see partnership, where we see marriage, where we see contracts, where we see engagement. And love affairs, in a sense, we look at this seventh house, we call it the worthy opponent. So this is somebody who sees you. They're from the opposite place of where you're at. They're in dristy with you. They're looking direct. They're looking at what you can't see. So in some ways, they know you better. All of this is activated. And when you got Uranus in the seventh and Mars transiting your seventh, Mars can be very pointed and sometimes cruel or aggressive, let's say. Uranus can have surprises and seem cold-hearted. And Venus is in the eighth. You want that intensity in love now. You're ready to experience a little passion, perhaps. And, you know, you got a nice social life to pull friends out of here and there. Keep working on your health. Oh. Hello, Scorpio, and welcome to your horoscope. So, what we're looking at here is another Mars ruled sign, but this time it's in your sixth house. And sixth house can be like the gymnasium. It can also be the place of service where we do our work. You know, a lot of countries have mandatory military service or government public service, and the sixth house would cover those areas. Charitable causes, people that need help, so we gather together to make something happen. This too is sixth house. Aunts and uncles, small pets, this is the sixth house. Your own personal health and health issues, this is affected by the sixth house. So you're like in this place now where you're like, I got to get myself in shape. Summer's coming and I am not going to look like my sexy Scorpio self if I've got a jelly belly or a muffin top, you know. So let's get to my full physical potential and make this thing work. Well, yeah, you know, Venus is in your seventh house now, transiting it. So relationships can actually be sweeter. They can be better than they have ever been before. And you've got way more power in your career life. Good things are happening. New opportunities are opening up for Scorpio. And I want you to be able to take full advantage of that. Feel really good about it. But it's somewhat of a pressure cooker because the sixth house gives you so much work. And so you just need to make sure you pace yourself, make sure you get enough sleep, make sure you do little things to honor what counts, like your love life, your spiritual life, those aesthetics. You need that stuff to keep yourself juiced. Well, hello Sagittarius, and welcome to your horoscope. So, what we're looking at right here is Saturn in the first house, but mostly a stellium of planets in the fifth. So what Saturn does is it helps us to be real with ourselves. And all of us need to get to that place where, okay, I understand I'm gifted or do well in a certain area, but in another area I'm a little more challenged. And I could use, and I'm open to making improvements so I can be as useful a person in all my relations as possible. You have a lot of creative juice right now. You have a lot of really creative ideas. Saturn's got the discipline, so I would say initiate and execute. Start things only with a plan to finish them and to get them ultimately published. Yeah, take it to the place where the idea is invented and it's copyrighted. Take it to the place where it is a true manifestation and not just some ridiculous pipe dream. What's your downside? Exaggeration, fickleness, inconsistency, flakiness. Okay, what's your good side or your positive side? It's generosity, spontaneity, courage, quick-wittedness, being able to be adaptable to a multitude of situations. All right then. So right now, you got to take all of your gifts and abilities. You know, your key phrase is, I visualize. This is a time of visualization where it leads to manifestation in the creative arts, with your children, in education, whether you're going into it as a teacher or a performing, especially performing artists, very big on the fifth house. Your heart motivates you to do the right thing. And so with this motivation, and with things working pretty well for you, you got Jupiter in the ninth house. I mean, travel's good. So many things are good. Do good. Well, hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your horoscope. So having Pluto in the first house. Now, I've had people come up to me and say, oh, man, Kozmic Kev, you know, I got Pluto transiting my first house, you know. It's like, dude, I live with this every day. You know? Yeah, I think for me, some of the greatest sorrow I've seen in my own lifetime is watch things of natural beauty go to waste. Right now there's a place near Superior, Arizona that has been opened up to a foreign government's copper mining. It's a beautiful valley full of oaks, black bear, bobcat, mountain lion, beautiful geology and geological formations, and a richer than you average flora and fauna, and a creek in Arizona where there's not a lot of water. And they want to destroy this place for copper mining. Well, and it's also Native peoples, you know, sacred spot too. And I hope all of you know that, you know, you earth sign Capricorns, that the whole earth is sacred. Now, I know that, like, since World War II and afterwards, you know, a lot of us were born as kind of like, especially late 50s on, when the space age hit, you know, sci-fi children. And some of us are so enamored with technology that we are so excited by what human potential is that we forget what the natural world and all the other living beings in it have potential. So for you, Capricorn, is manifest potential. Be cooperative with nature. That's really what Pluto and Capricorn's asking. It's like, don't forget about the Earth. You got a lot of family stuff right now brewing. It's bubbling, and it's causing a lot of tension and motivation in your life, with parents in particular. So give them extra love. Help your roommates, remodel your home, do what you got to do. But love the Earth while you're at it. Greetings, Aquarius. Welcome to your horoscope. So this is a time when we don't always are aware of how our knowledge is going to come into play. Now, Aries represents the neighborhood. It represents the environment. It represents the way you communicate. It represents people you've known since maybe grade school, high school, or college, your basic education years. It's also how you relay information and what your relationship to the environment is. And so for you, for Aquarians, the environment is a raw adventure, because really Aries is a raw adventure, folks. And that's why we love Aries so much, is because they make everything fresh. They're the fresh makers, for real. It's not some corporate logo. Aries are the fresh makers. You know, what we need now is just for you to make some good poetry, tell a good story, a good joke, maybe throw a neighborhood block party. Do things with your hands. A lot of times in the third house, we want to work with our hands, engage with our hands more. And relationship issues with Jupiter in the seventh house, they should be sweet. You know, you're gaining fun and wisdom. You know, and the worst part about Jupiter is sometimes people are irresponsible with the energy. They get into alcohol or drugs, you know, they're gamblers. They do foolish things with money, you know. There's ways of working with this. And you've got good older friends right now to help you. Well, hello, Pisces. Welcome to your horoscope. So what I'm seeing here is Mercury in the first house. So you've got this certain amount of intelligence. Neptune's there, you still have your spiritual view. Chiron's there, you still want to heal and help others. But we've got Mars, Sun, Uranus, Moon, South Node, all in your second house about money and resources. So either this is a time where you're making lots of money, or you're really needing lots of money, and you have to figure out how to enter into that field of economics and do it successfully. And so I think the biggest mistake people make in economics is being afraid to give. I think it's important to budget, but it's also important to pay tribute to those who economically need it more and represent the values that you have. That's how we empower and make world change, just with our own spare change. And it's all about your values. It's all about maybe a pain in your neck or a dental work that needs to be done. Any issue involving the second house, neck, ears, your hunger, friends of your family that are tagging on with you. Improve your health life. Accept that you are moving into a place of stronger leadership and that your friendships and your social circle are always going to have to change. So continue to be open to that, and good learning will take place from this time forward. Thanks for being with me this week. I'm looking forward to doing this again on the Planetary Persuader.
Citizen Television.